What's up, y'all? Welcome back. Pitchside with Parker. Now, today I have a very special video. Today's actually my birthday, and so I was racking my brain looking for video ideas for things that I could do that would kind of be topical to celebrate my birthday. And I decided that now that I am a washed up old man and a college graduate, and I am just a full-time adult these days, and the players that I'm often talking about in my videos are young guys who are excelling for their age. And in fact, my favorite club is currently being carried by a 19-year-old. I thought it would only be right to make a video about some of the best players in world football who are younger than me. So seeing as how it's my 23rd birthday today, I figured I would make a best 11 out of players who are 22 and under, who I would consider to be the players that will rule world football for the next several years. Now, some of them are really already there, and I'm sure that you could probably guess a few names off the top of your head. And so, you know, I don't intend for this in any way to be a controversial list or a ranking players better than another. I just thought it would be a fun topical video to do. So this is just a group of 11 players that make me feel incredibly old because they are all doing amazing things at their young age, and things that I only wish I could be doing at this age. But instead, I am sitting here in front of a camera talking about them. But anyway, before we get started, as always, be sure to subscribe to the channel if you're new around here. I do post daily content, which is leading me to come up with crackpot ideas like this one. But it's a good time around here. There will be a new video every single day, and you can count on that. So hit that subscribe button. Come along for the ride. We're building something here, and I'm really excited about it. And of course, hit the like before the video even gets started. That's what we do around here. And I mean, it's my birthday. Like, y'all could at least toss an extra like for that, I think. But anyway, let's get into the video. So as you notice, my background looks a little different. I can't lie, I feel a little naked without the board behind me. I like to have something kind of making a statement back here. But I'm actually gonna use the board to give you the lineup that I come up with today. And I am, as you can see, going with a 3-4-1-2. Simply out of the fact that there aren't a whole lot of great U23 defenders. Just a fact of the game, you know, it's hard to succeed as a defender at a young level. And I wanted to also fit as many of the great young attacking players into this lineup as I could. So don't judge me too harshly on the positions. They will be a mess. But we're gonna start with the front two, and I'm not gonna try to be trendy and be a hipster and give you a name you don't know. So I'm guessing you can probably guess the front two. So, as I'm sure you all guessed, ding, 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 it's Kylian Mbappe and Erling Haaland. Look, they have put on a show for us already in the Champions League this year. And, I mean, the fact that it's already getting to the point where we're talking about this being the new Messi versus Ronaldo, it's really pretty incredible. These guys have just laid out such a great foundation for their careers already. Their scoring numbers in the Champions League are bananas. I mean, Mbappe's already won a World Cup and been one of the brightest players at that World Cup. What more can we really say here? These guys are not just going to run football in the future. They run it right now. So, of course, they're in the U23 team. They're both younger than me. Crazy. So now on to the one that is beneath them in the formation, and also some might argue right beneath them in their rankings as well. Joao Felix, of course, is a young superstar in his own right. But, you know, I think I've come to have mixed feelings about Joao Felix, as a lot of people probably do, because it was just such a strange move, him going to Atletico. Now, you might remember in my Champions League preview when I said that I thought the stage was set for him to outshine both Mbappe and Haaland in the Champions League. That was a terrible take, and from the evidence that we saw against Chelsea in the first leg, there's only so much that Joao Felix can do in this Simeone team, and the fact that he's there with a 7-year deal is incredibly scary, and in my opinion, a little bit disappointing for the future of the world's game, because Joao Felix is awesome, and I want to see him thrive, and I want to see him in a much more attacking and a much more influential position in a team. And I think it's just hard because he gets compared so heavily to Mbappe and Haaland, who are already in such great situations and have already put up such crazy numbers. But he's right there with them, and he's definitely in my team. All right, so I've written down the midfield, and it is comprised of some of the best young English talents in the game. I mean, it is a golden generation coming through for England right now. So many good players under even 21. But here's our midfield four. I hope you can read these okay. But left to right, I mean, come on. It wasn't going to be a video without me putting Sokka in it. So, you already know what it is. Left side, we got Sokka. In the middle, Phil Foden and Sandro Tonali. Look, Phil Foden, to me, alongside Sokka, are the two brightest stars of the young generation. It's weird that we almost consider Sancho, who I've got out here on the right, to... He feels like he's almost a generation above them. Not like a full generation, but we've just seen him at the highest level for slightly longer than them. And Sokka and Foden are still more in that phase where they're breaking into the teams almost. Whereas Jadon Sancho already has 50 Bundesliga assists. The man is 21 years old. That's absolutely ridiculous. And let me tell you something. This guy would not be right here without Jadon Sancho. I promise you that. And people don't talk about it enough because, yes, Haaland is incredible for his age, and that's a fact. And all these guys have had great players around them as well. You know, Mbappe certainly is in a pretty good setup himself. But Haaland, a lot of his success has been fueled by Sancho. And when you watch them play together, the connection they have is unreal. And I actually think that when both of these guys move to new clubs, assuming that at some point it happens and they don't both stay at Dortmund, I think they might just struggle without each other. But hey, in my 11, they're going to have the link up. And I mean, Tonali is there as well. I think he's going to hold down Italian football for quite some time. He is definitely one of the generational midfielders coming through for them. Italy's kind of fallen off a little bit in terms of producing young talents and stuff, but this guy is class, and he's got a spot at AC Milan, and I just feel like he's going to be that guy there for a while. I mean, in terms of real center mids, because I'm forcing it a little bit here with Foden, this guy is definitely special, and he is definitely going to be a big name in the future. So we'll round things off with the back line, and this is where I had to get a little bit creative. This is where I had to get, you know, my inner number 10 going and you know, find a creative way to break through the team here. And we went with a set of outside backs here, really players who basically play as attackers, but they're defenders in this setup. And this team will not be playing any games together, so I'm not really too worried about the leaky back line. Of course, we got Alphonso Davies. It's actually crazy the level of his ascent going from MLS product to like, oh crap, this guy's pretty good and he's going to Bayern, to Champions League winner and his face is everywhere. And he's probably the best left back in the world. And he's only 20 years old. Absolutely absurd. And I can't wait to see how this guy's career develops, because he still has so much room to grow as a player as well. And the fact that he never even played left back his whole career, like he was a winger. And he made the transition so well in one of the best teams in the world. And he's in a situation where he's only gonna get better. That environment is perfect. As long as he can stay healthy, he is gonna be an absolute menace for years to come. And a CONCACAF legend. So he is the only CONCACAF player in this lineup. And I'm glad that he got a spot in there. Then, of course, Trent in the middle. I mean, he is kind of more along that line of Mbappe, Haaland, even Felix, you could argue, where his legacy is kind of already up there. He has made so many appearances for Liverpool at such a young age, and just being a part of the iconic moments for them, winning the title, winning the Champions League, the comeback against Barca, you know, corner taking quickly. That's Trent. He's already got his legacy there. He has slowed down a little bit this season, but, you know, how can you blame him without Van Dijk and without Gomez and without Matip and all the other center backs that have been out for them? I mean, it's tough to keep it up, and Liverpool have kind of been a mess on the whole. So I don't think he'll have any problems. And the only thing that's hard for him is there's so many good young English right backs. And so he currently is the cream of the crop, but he's going to have some work to do to stay ahead of them, despite the fact that he is 21 and he is the one setting the pace. But I mean, there's a lot of guys nibbling on his heels. So then we got Hakimi, and I think this guy flies under the radar. I gotta be honest with you. Like, first of all, I don't really understand why Real Madrid haven't kept him. He has been awesome for Inter, and it's not like Madrid have done well at the right back position. They've been playing Lucas Vazquez there all season. So yeah, very questionable why they let him go. I feel like they might end up having to buy him back at some point if they're able to swallow their pride, because this dude is class. And somehow he is also younger than me as well. It feels like so many of these guys have been just around for a long, long time. We have known about them. And yeah, they're my age mates, or even younger, most of them. Anyway, finally in goal, we got Gianluigi Donnarumma. And he's another one that makes me feel really old, because as I was researching this, I learned that he's made 200 appearances for AC Milan. And he's younger than me. I mean, I'm coming up on 100 videos on this channel, and I thought that was quite a milestone. This dude has played in 200 professional games for one of the biggest clubs in Italy, which is absolutely ridiculous. But he started when he was like 18, so that's how we have that. He's 22 now. But he is definitely the future as well. So, you know, with him and Tonali, Italy certainly have a base to build around. But yeah, that's the team. The 3-4-1-2. We had to get a little creative. Here's a closer look in case it wasn't too easy to see throughout the video. But yeah, man, this was, you know, just a little fun video. I hope y'all enjoyed it. Definitely let me know if you did in the comments. I figured it would be kind of a cool way to kind of keep things in perspective since it's my birthday, just looking at what some of these young guys are doing, and this is why the game is so fun. Like, you see I've been smiling throughout this whole video because football is in good hands, man. Like, these are the guys that we get to talk about for years and years and years on end. And as we are kind of witnessing this end of Messi and Ronaldo, and who is going to take the throne from these guys, they're already here, man. We've got so much to be excited about. It just feels like there's soccer on all the time, constantly. We are just saturated with it. And especially here in America, I just feel like it's going to keep growing. And these guys will become household names here before we know it. I really do think that. But yeah, that's going to be all for this video. If you enjoyed it, smash the thumbs up on this video if you didn't already. And, you know, it is my birthday, so a little extra love would be appreciated. It would go a long way. And also be sure to subscribe to the channel if you're new. I do videos every single day, and there are all kinds of different videos, some match reviews, some videos like this, all kinds of other stuff. And, you know, if you click around my channel, I'm sure you'll find something that you like. So with that being said, that's going to be all for this one, and I will catch y'all in the next video. Peace.